preventing crime and investigating crime. But we're also fighting the communication battle. We actually have to win that battle as well for the hearts and minds of our children. If the social network sites are being used in a particular way, I think that we have to come to it. And sometimes, I hope that I'm not being unfair, but sometimes I feel that some people who go on these sites and use them, they would like to keep Barbados in a state of siege. You look at some of the things that are on the site and you wonder the motivation for the thing. In relation to the other murders, we recorded, our statistics show that we recorded 13 murders over the last four months. And today, we saw 10 of them. And for the year so far, there's a rate of clearance of about 70%. There's one murder in particular, the one that occurred at Hunger's Gap of Westbury Road, involving the death of Shakane Worrell. You remember, he's of school age, a pupil. That has caused some public outrage as well. And we recently met with his mother and family members to give them an update on our investigation and also to provide some reassurance. And we are making some progress on that murder as well. And I'm quite confident that we will have a satisfactory outcome in due course. There's some other matters. I believe that I know that the public relations officer has been raising the issues with you, including the stolen car racket. At the time he spoke, he did say that he had recovered four vehicles, three or four vehicles at the time. And since then, we've recovered four others. Now we are seeking a young man in connection with this car racket. And my advice to him is that he should turn himself in without further delay. The cash for gold and problem continues. I did say when last I met with you that this was fueling some of the problems we have on our streets, theft from prison and robberies and so on. I can say that we have made a submission to our ministry, the Office of the Attorney General, seeking for additional legislative support to more efficiently regulate this problem. The issue of road policing, again, when we met last time, I spoke about the problems of a person using cars to move around Barbados and commit crime. I'm aware that the Ministry of Public Works are moving to address the issue of false registration plates. And I can say that later today we're going to have a presentation from a provider who is offering a solution which perhaps will be considered by us and the Minister of Public Works to bring an end to this vexing problem. I want to say though that amidst all that we've witnessed in over the last couple of weeks, that the sky is not falling. There's no imminent collapse for society here in Barbados. There are worrying signs, yes, but I believe as a society we can fix those problems. High rates of crime are not inevitable. Here in the forest, we have been quietly doing the required analysis, and particularly we've been looking at the motivation for offending. There's been substantial work done by our crime intelligence unit. And there is a unique opportunity for us to share the information with government and and the other agencies of the city, such that we would bring a more balanced and measured approach to the difficulties that we are experiencing with crime in our area, in our country. Of course, crime will generate fear, but I have to say that some of the debate has been shallow. It has even encouraged some ad hominem attacks. I'm saying that a lot of the analyses that we are bringing to bear could be used for intervention, targeted intervention in some of our societies, and also for crime prevention. There's one significant bar though, and some of what we discovered we cannot share with the public because of our system of jurisprudence. Persons who are charged with crime are guaranteed a fair trial. And so we should be very wary of saying anything that would be prejudicial to their trial. I can say that since my last press conference, we did have an opportunity to attend a meeting of the Cabinet Subcommittee on Social Policy. And we shared some of our findings at that meeting. And I am certain that it is going to assist in policy formulation and appropriate intervention in some of our troubled communities. One other issue that we recognize needed attention, and we started to do that, is the problem of managing persistent offenders. We would recognize that even though there is new offending, persons come on to the or start their criminal career, we have been affected by persistent offenders, and so we put systems in place in our organization to manage those persistent offenders. I believe that that is going to pay some rich dividends. Word about our communities are the foundation of our country, and as I said on previous occasions, some of them are framed, and so we're going to have to do some work to reweave the fabric of our community. I noticed that the church is going to have a debate on crime, I believe, sometime next week, and we look forward with anticipation to joining that debate and making our contribution at that symposium when it comes up next week. I know that it's uncomfortable in this room today, so I'm going to be very brief, but in anticipating your questions, I know you're going to ask me something about our deported population. Now, we started keeping records of deported beginning in the year 1987, and the Vastly Crime Intelligence Unit to look at what has been happening for the last 5 years between 2006 and 2010. I can tell you that our database reveals that we have a deported population of 1,037, and that between 2006 and 2010, 264 persons were sent back here to Barbados. That deporting mirrors almost exactly the general offender population in Barbados. Of course, we're going to have to do some more analysis of these statistics, but I can say that before you ask me, that there is no runaway situation with crime committed by deporting population in Barbados. One other matter before I take your question is the misuse of the social media network. My public relations officer insisted that I should raise this issue. I think sometime last week there was a message circulating on BBM that some police officers were shot. And until that RSS board jammed with the call about that. And it does seem that people continue to misuse the social media and network. And I have to say that it was responsible for a lot of the panic that ensued in the country following those kind of incidents, of which I spoke. And so I want to say that the force of work has worked very hard over the last week to bring some resolution to these matters. It has been an outstanding performance by our investigators and those persons in the back office who support them. Some of them who cannot be publicly recognized and they want to. So thank all of them who have really put their shoulders to the plow to bring us out of that little bump for this fight in this process and trend. And I just want to see again that the sky is not falling. Our society is not on the point for that. A matter that has been discussed extensively throughout the region, I believe that the region as a community represented by some agencies have had significant discussion, particularly with the US and to a lesser extent with Canada and the UK. And they've asked for the very issues that you've raised, more information on properties, and that they should have access to any property that they might have acquired when they live in those countries. I think that one of the issues that has been raised is that the assistance with their resettlement in Barbados. Like, I believe that of all the initiatives that have been put to the sending countries, perhaps that is the one that has been getting the most traction, let's put it that way, particularly in Jamaica. But yes, it's a problem. What you say is true. I've seen instances of persons who have left Barbados very tender age, 2-3 years, I think, for a substantial time in those countries and then return to our country. I know that CARICOM commissioned 3 studies. One was done in, I think, Jamaica, one was done in Trinidad, and one was done in Antigua. People will dispute the findings. There's a feeling around the region that Portuguese commit a lot of crime. So I've seen the case in Barbados where this person is not being a prolific criminal, but to get into his mind, I feel that he has returned to the country and it is expected that he will behave in a particular way. And so as to be a self-fulfilling prophecy. He's done some things. He's gone into jail, I suppose, and come out with a badge of honor and so on. It is amazing once you start to get into the mind of criminals, what you can find. That is why I'm saying that the debate on crime in Barbados has to be premised on facts rather than whims and so on. And so he looks forward to the symposium and so on. And that will be held in due course.